Oh, how is everyone today? How are you, Mist? How are you, Scarecrow? Scarecrow, thank you for the 5 months subscribed. I do appreciate that, and I hope you know that. Ugh. Guys, I am not feeling well today, so we're gonna see how this goes. I'm not guaranteeing I'm gonna be at my best. But I do want to play this and see if it gets my mind off feeling bad. And use a little bit of psychology to make myself feel better. So how are both of you doing? How are you, Scarecrow? How are you, Mist? Did you have a good weekend? I hope you did. I'm going to go around here while we're kind of getting started and see what all I can do. I don't remember this portion of the game very much. Looks like we got everybody to talk to that is in the party. Somebody named Levi Dryden. There are those guys we met as we ended the game last week. And I think I can hear this thing mooing. You mooing? Meow. He is mooing. By goodness, he is mooing. Yeah, mine's mainly like stomach issues, so I'm not like, it'll pass. I know it'll pass, right? But why would an ox be meowing? It's just what oxes do in this game. It's probably one of the mods I screwed up. Right? Check out the new Fanatical Build Yourself a Birthday Bundle. There are a few higher priced games in there. As always, check out the games before you buy. Of course. I will. I'll check those out. If there's any new ones, I won't mind to see if there's any that I might want, or I might want to throw in the giveaways. I actually did do all of the giveaways that I needed, like all the games, and collabed all the codes that I have to give away this Sunday. I'm going to wait to do the channel points until after that giveaway, and then I'll put them as channel point giveaways as well throughout the week. Or throughout the month before we do the community giveaways each month is what I'm trying to do. One of the things that I'm going to do is I'm going to make different tiers of games, and I'm going to do them. I like mapped them out a little bit of the prices that they were and like how many points they should be in my opinion. But some of them I just went ahead and did it as, I don't think this deserves to be a high priced or a high point game, even though it's a high priced game. So I'll look at Fanatical and see if there's going to be some adding on to those, or if I want to get some myself. Saw your camp and thought to myself, what safer place to rest for the evening than in the camp of a Grey Warden? I'm perfectly willing to offer you a fine discount for the inconvenience of our presence. How does that sound? Good? Yes? You are free to stay. Just mind yourselves. Wonderful. Thank the gentleman. Way cheaper than Humble Bundle. Thank you, sir. Yeah, I wasn't too thrilled about Humble this week. I assure you. You should need enchantments. Simply talk to my boy. Otherwise, come speak with me. Enchantments? I do remember him doing that. All right, Sandal. Always a bit simple, but he's rather good with enchantments. One of those tranquil fellas actually called him a savant. I had no idea such a thing existed. And I'm also sorry to hear about you not feeling your best today, Scarecrow, but hopefully we'll get that fixed for you. Mist, how much does our daylight savings time affect you guys in Europe when you're trying to watch a streamer that has to adjust their time based on that? What enchantments does he do? Almost any
weapon or piece of armor, though naturally some of the more extravagant materials will take more lyrium than others. It's a process that some of the master smiths back in Orzammar will perform, but my boy...
11 p.m. where you're at. Adept at it. Isn't that right, boy? That is too bad.
And there you have it.
I want to get some enchanting done. Actually, I don't. I just want to see how this works. So we can't enchant. They don't have slots. I gotcha. All right. I remember how that works now.
Anything I can do for you, please, please tell me.
There is. I want to see your wares.
Please, with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
All right. Do I have stuff to sell? I'm sure I do. Ash Warrior's axe. Let's get rid of that. Enchanted dagger. Let's get rid of all those. Great sword. See you around. Oathkeeper's probably a good sword. Let's see if Alistair might need that. Kunari thickened cap. Soldier's helmet. Heavy chainmail gloves. Heavy chainmail boots. We'll keep the Grey Warden shield. We'll hold off for now. I think it might be enough to get us through the portion where we get a stash. Is this your normal time? Yeah, so this is the same time exactly. Well, you mean normal time of daylight savings. I guess this would be considered our normal time. Right, Scarecrow? Like, during the summer months, we move ahead. I don't know anymore, Miss, to be honest. I think daylight savings time is one of the stupidest things that we do here in America. It probably had its value back when it was done, but now it's not, so... Yeah, like I'm getting on at 5, which I guess would be normally what would have been 6 last week. But I don't like it. I've not adjusted to it very well. I got tired really early yesterday and woke up really early today.
Old man to find. Where are my manners? The name is Levy. Levy Dryden. Did Duncan ever mention me? Levy of the coins? Levy the trader?
No. I'm Bijax. I've never heard of you.
He never told you of old Levy? We've known each other for years. But here I am carrying on while you have a blight to stop. Don't want to waste your time. But you see, Duncan promised that together we'd look into something important for the Wardens. And for me. But poor Duncan's. Well, no more. A tragedy it is, at that. But I know he would want his work carried on, his pledge fulfilled.
What promise did Duncan make you?
My family's name is Mud around noble circles. My great-great-grandmother, Sophia Dryden, was the last Warden Commander of Ferelden back when the Wardens were known as Freeloaders. So King Orland banished the Wardens, and he took House Dryden's land and titles.
What happened next?
Hard to say. After King Orland died, there was a civil war, loads worse than this one, and our family was on the run, hunted by enemies, with nary a friend in the world. But Drydens are tough. We rebuilt, became merchants, and we never lost our pride.
I'm surprised you've kept your name.
Our family's only crime was guarding the kingdom against the Blight. We're not ashamed of that.
So what favor did Duncan... Did you ask Duncan?
I asked for the truth. My family reveres Sophia Dryden. We know she died at the old Grey Warden base, Soldier's Peak. We want evidence to clear her name. It won't restore our land or our titles, but it'll restore our...
This is what we're going to do next, because I think this is where I get my stash. I've never heard of Soldier's Peak.
Well, no one's been to Soldier's Peak since Ireland's days. At least none that's come back. I spent years mapping the maze of tunnels to the peak, and
away a few years back. So I went to Duncan, I did, and I said that he could reclaim the old base and my family could have its honor.
What do you need from me?
I can pick my way through the tunnels at the base of Soldier's Peak, but the place, well, they say it's haunted, and it'll be dangerous for certain.
A haunted base. Your family's faith will be rewarded. I will help you.
Blessings upon you, Warden. I'll mark down the location on your map. When you arrive, we'll pick our way through the tunnels together.
That sounds good. I won't start today by doing all these, talking to everybody, so we will just go ahead and get right into it. Alright, so our party is going to be myself, Alistair, Morgan, and Liliana. Party camp, that's Flemeth's hut. There's the where the elves are. That's where we were at. Well, thank you for the follow. Is it, how do we say your name? Tote? The sloth, I got that in the back. I can call you sloth if you're good with that. But thank you very much for the follow. I hope you enjoy your time here. We are day two of playing Dragon Age Origins. It's the first time I've played in a long time, heavily modded. And we are heading off to the Warden's base once I find where it's at. Up there, Soldier's Peak. Head to Soldier's Peak. It's gonna be a long way. We'll probably have an encounter before then. This is one of the best games ever made. It's one of my favorites, but I have not played it in probably 10 years. So, came back to play it and wanted to do a heavily modded version of it. Different character looks, some HD up-reses, and a more real, is what they call it, mod pack that kind of makes things more real than, say, a more realistic or more lore-centric. So we'll see how that is. Told you the map through the tunnel. Just admit it, you were lost a couple times. No. Let's say Adraste's blood. How did you find that path on your own?
Believe me if I told you.
So who is your favorite companion, Sloth? Just admit it, you were lost a couple times. You've never played with mods. Well, this is my first time playing this game with mods as well, so maybe you'll see something you like and want to jump back in.
I expect there's trouble up ahead.
Soldier's Peak. Looks like it's seen better days.
Alright. Once the wardens flourished, been gone long enough. I know the majority of the story, but I do not remember the specifics of the portions of some of these, especially the DLC. I think I only played the DLC once. Ogryn's a great character.
Fall back already!
Taking the peak will not be easy, my lord.
I gave the wardens one chance to die with honor. Instead, they hole up like cowards. We follow the king's advice, then. Starve them out.
But the peak has months of supplies.
Then we wait. When they are too weak to lift their weapons, we will send them to their final judgment.
Alright. So we're seeing the king's men come to attack.
What was that? Felt a bit woozy then.
Gotcha.
I'm not mad, am I? You saw it too.
I've heard an Orlesian ballad about something like this.
Your first few D&D characters were drunken dwarfs because of Ogryn. Hey, you know what?
Pretty friendly.
I think it's a pretty good start. I'm a D&D player, actually mainly a DM. I've not really played probably 15 years. So most of my time is behind the screen. The world is full of mysteries. Alright, we're going to be facing ghosts, aren't we? Our username is Barbarian Subclass in 5e. totem of the sloth. Why could I not see that? Yes. That is an arcana. Subclass, right? Who leveled up? Dog leveled up. Yeah. We're gonna make his strength go up. What is your favorite D&D class? Is it a barbarian or great. So just these in front of us. Yeah, one of the many hundreds of the totem subclasses. You are right about that. Imagine Jack's missing a D&D reference. I suck at trying to figure out what people's usernames are. You are right. Imagine me, of all people, missing that up. Oh, they're coming behind us. You like Bard, so you know what, whenever I would play, if I did really play, most of the times if I actually make a character, it's to help another friend who's DMing a session. I like to play Bard classes and just help out a little bit during combat, but mainly just have great skills for some role playing. Wow. Are they just gonna keep coming? You got in and you can't even spell Dungeons and Dragons? Well, Scarecrow, why didn't you help a friend out? We must do something. Didn't realize that Alistair had fell. Not in your mods contract? Well, what do I need to alter that mods contract to get it up? What did he have on him? Anything good? Crossbow. Alright, we'll take those. Actually, per Pathfinder. So, here's an interesting thing. While I prefer 5e just because when I create my own content, it's much easier to adapt to. But I prefer the Pathfinder stories way more than I do any of the Dungeons & Dragons stories. So, like, one of my best purchases was on a Humble Bundle. I bought, I don't know, probably 1,000 Pathfinder books. And I just went through them and picked out the stories that I thought were the best and ended up just adapting them into a 5e campaign. So, what do you like about Pathfinder that's that has you enjoying it more? It is an interesting universe. This poster reads, "On these grounds, virtuous men stood against a tyrant. They stood defiant and stood for freedom, and they died." It is signed by the Grey Warden defenders who were besieged by King Arlen's forces. Captain Mello, the Black Ferret, Chained Chair Thrower Lopez, Sir Derek Orlay, and Jason the Longbow. Alan the Quilber, Cartography Martyr, David the Silent, Dustin the Colorblind, Ebinger the Bovine Brethren, Farrell the Feral, Sir Graham the Untiring, and Jason Sands, Les Argonauts. Oh, they still go. Langley the Nefarious, Lucky Lacuna, Mad Dog Smeadows, Matthias the Bloody, McGurk the Vile Priest, Melissa the Magical Malefactor, Alm the Stretched, and Packrat Dirksen. Sergeant Red Morris and Santos the Silent Scimitar, Vitrilic Eric, We guide Santos and well burn the exhausted fire. Those are some names, I tell you that. Read names faster? That's not in my streamer contract. Warhammer levels of lore? Yes, Warhammer does have some great, great lore. I really wish Warhammer Online would have done better. You like the combat better? You know what? I probably will agree with you. The combat is a... it's just meatier and more satisfying. Really, the only problem I had with Pathfinder is I had a hard time getting people into it. They saw it after playing D&D and just felt, this is too much. I'm not going there.
So brave, even when starving, and my great-great-grandmother stood with them.
Sounds like there is greatness in your blood.
Well, that's kind of you to say. Generations of Drydens have said that our stock were lions, fierce, proud, and noble. But I've gabbed enough. Lead on, my...
Did you hear Wilbur the Holy Woolly Mammoth as one of those names? It probably could have been. Alright, so to recap why we're here. Levi here. His mom was a commander of the Grey Wardens when a king declared them nothing, greedy, and kicked them out. And it looks like the king sent his troops here to kill him. And his mother, Levi's mother, the commander of the Grey Wardens at that time, held out against them. And it looks like some bad stuff happened because their spirits are still here and moving about and causing some issues. What is this? An arcane horror. Oh my goodness. They are just burning me alive. I forgot to save, I tell you that. Okay, get up, guys. Remind me to F5 more often. Best thing about 5e is that it's so streamlined for new players. Yep. Lots of new players get into it with Critical Role. Yeah, that is me. It is, I found Critical Role from a colleague that I used to write campaigns with. Thank you, Scarecrow. And he told me about them probably, I think I watched them, this is part where I cannot remember entirely, but on their third or fourth episode of campaign one, about as my injuries. Penalty to fatigue, remove this injury, use an injury kit, or visit the party camp. Let's get rid of these. See, I've been watching Critical Role for a long time, and I agree with you about 5e. It's streamlined. I compared it at one point to 5e did what did to D&D or tabletop gaming what World of Warcraft did for RPGs, MMORPGs. It made it easy enough for just about anybody to play, but it still was... solid enough to... Oh my goodness, this is hard. Still solid enough for people to have a lot of fun with it. Oh no, hit. Come on, hit. You started on 3.5 sets. Yeah, so I started, it would have been a version of 2. I could say my older brother got me in, or started playing. He played the original, but I was too young to quite understand what he was doing. I started with 2, 3.5 is really good. I that's probably where I got into it. That's when I started to really DM. But I think I came into my own with 5e because I was able to do things that I wanted to in it at that point. Right? I didn't have, feel like I had to follow a campaign book. And I've had a... It's funny, I've written short stories, like fantasy short stories, for since I was like 10. And now I'm able to take those fantasy short stories and turn them into D&D campaigns, which is a lot of fun. I've been trying to get the people that I normally play with to do an online version. They do not want to. However, I am working on maps right now and some digital editing to see if I can actually do 30-minute campaign sessions where I tell the story, like on YouTube, and make it to where it might be entertaining for some people to listen to and have some visual elements in there. Just to share my stories, and I don't know if you're like me, most of my ideas come from other people, right? So I'd like to put them back out there for other people to maybe get to enjoy the same thing. Oh. Let's go read this book. This book is badly burned. You can make a word out here and there, and that is all.
The door won't hold on.
Almost done. The truth must be told.
Yep.
What does it matter? We're dead.
I've rewrote some of my history to my campaigns based off Critical Role. But the stories that I have it based off of are heavily inspired by Dune. That was my favorite book growing up. And then some campaigns actually got inspired by this game right here. I have a campaign that is it's called the Ebon Rook Island campaign. And it is inspired 100% by the way Dragon Age Origins does their quests, where you can do a bunch of stuff, right? But not everything's going to be available to you. Things will get taken over. The evil does continue to make its way into the place and lock you out of content. And, make things more difficult for you, or sometimes easier for you. I said Dune, D-U-N-E. I still ride or die that's the best novel, fantasy novel ever written. Rebellion is against everything the Warden stood for.
The Wardens are heroes. Some injustices just can't be ignored.
Perhaps we will find more answers inside. Alright. Okay. Keep forgetting that you can just look up little books and get codex entries for a good amount of XP. You played a Sky Pirates campaign a few years ago inspired heavily by Firefly. That sounds like it would be awesome.